We invite you to stand at attention as we do our national anthem, after which we invite Pastor Kendall Augustine to do the opening prayer for us. Let's all stand at attention.
Let us pray. Jehovah God, Almighty Father, Alpha and Omega, I call on you today to look upon this ceremony in your grace and mercy and grant your favor to it. In all of the happenings today, let your mind and your heart be known. I pray for the graduates that while today is one of reflection and celebration, would you cause it to also be a moment where many are activated and launched into the foreordained purpose and calling you have for them. Father, in your name I decree that even today seeds of righteousness and divine purpose would be planted and switched on in their hearts. As the Apostle Paul charged Timothy, I pray this charge on them, that they will let no one despise their youth, but through your miraculous intervention, O God, they would find themselves an example to people in speech, in conduct, in agape, in faith, and in purity. Lord God, I lift SCSS as a whole before you today. While those in agreement, I ask that even today you would initiate a new era of academic success, character formation, moral flourishing going forward. Once again, Father God, I ask that you would pour out your presence, that you would favor this ceremony with your grace. In Jesus' name, amen.
You should now be seated.
District Representative for Soufriere Fonseja, Honorable Emma Hippolyte.
Representative from the Ministry of Education.
District Education Officer, Mrs. Joel Charlemagne.
Pastor Kendall Augustine.
Acting Principal of the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School, Miss Crescentia Combi.
Acting Vice Principal of the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School, Mr. Zion Williams.
Principals of District 8.
Guest Speaker.
Specially invited guests.
Parents.
Members of the media.
And graduates.
Good afternoon and welcome to the 44th annual graduation ceremony of the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School. It is an honor for us to be your hosts this afternoon. I am Chanel Ferguson and along with me today is
Cedron Theodil. Graduates, you have made it through the mountains of knowledge, through the seas of your insecurities, through the dust of COVID-19. Some of you, through countless suspensions that you learn valuable lessons from. But I want you to look around you right now. Each of you, look around. You deserve to be here today. I want everyone to say, I deserve to be here. Say it again, I deserve to be here. Our theme for this graduation, Real World Readiness, an evolution of thought and behavior. Real World Readiness, an evolution of thought and behavior.
Indeed, at this time we invite Ms. Christine Shekombi, the acting principal of the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School, to deliver the principal's report. Let's put our hands together to welcome Ms. Combi.
Good afternoon, everybody. The protocol list was supposed to include a lot of people who I have not seen. But either way, we will say good afternoon to them. They are there in spirit or on their way. All our officials, our invited guests, our vice principal, Mr. Zion Williams, staff, invited guests, our distinguished sponsors, parents, and most especially our esteemed graduates, whom all of this fanfare is for. I welcome you to this auspicious 44th graduation ceremony of the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School. It is an honor to be here today to speak on behalf of this institution of stellar repute. The students before us began their journey at SCSS in 2018. Just as mine began in administration. This group of students were the first whom I addressed as vice principal. Today, they are the first group of students whom I will address at a graduation ceremony as acting principal. The juxtaposition of our journeys in the life of the school presents the experience of battles. Many challenges which we may not yet have conquered, but more importantly, many victories which must be celebrated. It may be argued that the greatest challenge which faced this group of students during their 5 years was the COVID-19 pandemic. The effects of frozen movement frozen in time, only captured in Hollywood, became a reality, if not but for a moment. The graduates here would have found themselves smack in the middle of the most tumultuous time of an individual's life, adolescence. Adults, if you remember anything from that period in your life, you would acknowledge that from Form 3, there was a turnaround for secondary school class, the time when all teachers would comment on how much you have changed. This is characteristic of individual development. Ladies and gentlemen, our graduates today faced in these challenges during a melange of shutdowns, restrictions, death, uncertainty, fear, panic, conspiracy, all of those theories, and of course, teenage theatrics, the struggle between childhood and adulthood, the need to interact with their peers, the loss of income in their homes, the dreaded online learning, just to name a few. I think that it is these experiences which have caused staff to empathize with the students here today. These students stood out when compared to other forms for their exhibition of mass confusion. When they received many speeches about over the last few terms, their homeroom teachers and form dean, their dean, of course, with an unidentified number of years of service in this noble profession, were oftentimes stupefied by the ingenuity of the students' avoidance of hard work, their playfulness, their childish pranks. We think that they all masked these fears and uncertainty. Everybody would literally SMH. The motivational activities, talks, the anger, the tears, and of course the praise made this journey one of the most interesting ones of all time for staff and students. We only hope that the results of this year's examinations provide us with the proverbial happy ending for SCSS. This academic year, 2022 to 2023, epitomized greatness, the greatness which we want fostered in our students even when they leave the walls of SCSS. As usual, our sporting prowess was commendable. Hats off to the coaches and athletes for making our successes possible. We were able to make it to the final of many of the sports in which we participated. We are school basketball's royalty, the first ever national inter-school female basketballerama championship. Gave SCSS females, including some of our graduates here, the opportunity to show the nation SCSS girl power. Please stand for a moment, ladies, so we can see who you were. Our basketballers. Stand up so people can see you. It's your day. We're celebrating you. Put your hands together for them, please. I don't see Daisy. Daisy, where are you? You were in the room. The males also shone as we made it to both finals. Under 15 in the ballerama, we were the champions. And under 19, we went in and came in second. Stand so we can see you as well. The students who participated in basketball, let me see you. It's your day. Stand so people can see you as well. Woo! Make it fast, make it fast. Thank you. The footballers battled tete-a-tete with the St. Lucia Sports Academy in the finals of the under-19 competition and lost after the game went to penalties. We know how that goes. I think we should be considered an academy ourselves. Policymakers, take note. Stand and take a bow, gentlemen. Footballers. All right. Table tennis also presented us with an opportunity to shine. We are not as seasoned in the sport, but made an impressive appearance during last year's tournament, particularly in the team competition. Ladies and gentlemen, who made us proud, please stand. Now, some of the students will be tired of standing because they were in lots of sports, but stand, it's your day. Thank you. Our road race team. Over the years, we boast. The team had our greens extending as far as our cheeks could go. We were able to amass medals, three of which came from this graduating class. Second place female under 18, first and second male under 18, and a third place under 16 who's upcoming. Please stand, lady and gentlemen. Next, the volleyballers presented us with opportunities to shine. Under 19 male volleyballers got us as far as the semi-final round, and their efforts were equally celebrated. Let us see you, ladies and gentlemen, volleyballers. The females were in the finals, and the males were in the semis. We have no female volleyballers? Oh, that's what I'm saying! Our cricketers have struggled due to the lack of a play area, but persisted and did well. The under-15s made it to the semi-final, but unfortunately did not go further. We take this opportunity to make a plea for a space which fosters the development of cricket. Who knows, a cadre of SCSS males and females may resuscitate West Indies cricket from this coma if we are provided with adequate resources. Cricketers, take a bow. Let me see you, the cricketers. All right. The inter-secondary school track and field championships, newly branded Island Champs, also brought in success. Watching our ladies and gentlemen glide over the tracks in these 4x4 relays brought pure joy. To all of you who represented, please stand, it's your day. The boys, our 4x4 gold medalists, thank you very much. Let us also recognize the efforts of the head of the sports department, Mr. Mark Antoine, for years of great leadership, the consistent football coaching from Sir Charles, our beautiful MC over here, Mrs. Ferguson, and assistant Miss Hippolyte, for the consistent netball performance, Miss Emmanuel, Mr. Vincent Jean-Philippe, Mr. Delta's Jean-Philippe, Miss Pascal, and the boss lady herself, Miss Emina Atil Antoine, who takes care of the administrative work of the sports department. If anyone dares to doubt that teamwork makes the dream work, they need to come to SCSS. Pardon me for taking that much time to individually highlight sports, but if we do not take time to blow our trumpet and appreciate ourselves, who will? Sports is not our only area for celebration or cause of celebration this year. We have done exceptionally in the area of sustainable development and environmental science. We had 4 students who participated and won prizes in the Oceans Day Art Competition. This resulted in their works being displayed in a special edition calendar. Our aquaponics project also won a 2nd place in the Macmillan Young Caribbean Environmental Scientist of the Year competition 2022-2023. This is a regional competition. Our artistic talents, nurtured by the capable teachers, also resulted in a 2nd and 3rd runner-up prizes in the Art of Adapting, a Climate Solution Creative Art Competition, with pieces entitled Messy Blue and Visible from Space. Science. The National Science Fair hosted by KAMDU has been an area for us to shine as well. We placed 2nd in the lower secondary school category with a project entitled 3D Springs. The students used their technology and took drone footage of the sulfur springs, mapped out moving springs. Interesting, you may take a look. This year, we are the winners of the Ministry of Commerce Taiwan Trade Show video competition. I am certain that the parliamentary representative and the Minister of Commerce was extremely proud of her alma mater and her constituency for winning this competition. Our participation in activities of language and culture have not gone unrewarded. We gained 2nd place in the Francophonie Creole Poetry Competition. Students also gained prizes in the George Odlum Essay Competition, and we are currently engaging in the Ministry of Tourism Public Speaking Competition. On a school level, the students have made us proud and embodied the values of leadership and industry. They have perpetuated the spirit of community and the vision of success through many school projects. The general construction and carpentry classes have created several projects on compound. These include the renovation of the science lab, working stations, the renovation of the doors on the A block, and the commencement of a sustainable project entitled Wall Speak. We ask today that our corporate sponsors, parents, past students, present help with this project. Psychologists have revealed the power of positive words. Positive words continuously reaffirmed in the mind through display on walls. This is not all that we have to talk about, but my time is limited. The results of last year's CSEC exams reveal the resilience, hard work, and dedication of the majority of our students, our teachers, and our parents. Next year's results in the principal's report will be yours. I hope they are as outstanding. We attained a 100% pass rate in, help me list, agriculture, biology, electronic document preparation and management, English B, food nutrition and health, French, geography, building technology, information technology, office administration, physical education and sport, principles of accounts, Spanish, technical drawing, and visual arts. I think your school deserves a clap after all of these 100% pass rates. We also had very high averages in the 90s, high 90s and 80s in principles of business and social studies. And thankfully, results for English were reviewed and our pass rate has climbed to above 70. In total, since we now have the new results, we did not have chemistry. Chemistry came in late. We got 100% pass in chemistry as well. Our average, which was initially 80.25, did surpass that. So clap for your students. We attained above 80% in CXC. One of the highlights of this year is the collaboration of stakeholders in the review of the mission and vision of the school. We applaud the students, represented by the Students' Council, the staff, the parents, the Ministry of Education, represented by the Education Officer, and corporate sponsors who were able to attend the review of our vision and mission statements. We have changed our vision from being one of the 5 most effective secondary schools on island, because we are the best school on the island. We changed to an educational institution which caters to the holistic development of students through the development of their talent and sustainable practices. We hope that consultations of this nature continue, as the school is a community school with vested interest in student success. Our collaboration with the Parent Teacher Association has also resulted in positive outcomes. We are able to submit all documents to officially register the organization with the government of St. Lucia. We successfully hosted workshops in collaboration with the Ministry of Health to address the socio-emotional needs of the adolescents in our care. SCSS believes in catering to all dimensions of self and promotes strategic partnerships with all stakeholders to ensure the success of all individuals and ultimately the institution as a whole. The most alluring feature of this institution is its ability to cater to individual needs. We pride ourselves on our ability to create opportunities for every child to receive a measure of success. As the only secondary school in District 8, we must be provided with the resources to cater to all our students. We are not in the business of elitist or divisive education, and we would love that the government of St. Lucia provide us with the resources which will allow us to cater to all who seek secondary education at our school. Our greatest challenge as an institution has been the inability of our superiors to greatly support our vision for the school and the communities which our students come from. The provision of adequate and suitable infrastructure and other necessary capital, which would alleviate several of our stresses, is not provided. To this end, though, I thank Honorable Hippolyte for her efforts in securing a temporary block to cater to the arts and skills which we are excelling at, not only nationally, but regionally as well. We, however, await with bated breath, I hope we don't run out of oxygen, the new block which would facilitate inclusivity and diversity in our education system. This year's theme is most apt, as it aligns with our new vision, an old vision really, expressed newly in writing. Whilst we encourage students and ourselves to dream big, we must do so within the context of our reality. This theme encourages us to acknowledge where we are and determine where we would like to go. According to Albert Einstein, a very popular saying which may have been cliched but is very relevant, the definition of insanity is doing the same over and over and expecting different results. We affirm that we are not insane, at least not clinically so. This is why, after examining our realities, we will employ evolutionary thought and behavior to create the realities that we want. These principles guide the fulfillment of the prescription of our curriculum and are founded heavily on the premise of good behavior. We are sometimes complained for being too strict. However, we emphasize that the discipline with which we carry out our daily activities is paramount to our success as students and adults. In the face of adversity, press on for your good, the good of your family and your nation. Although this part of the ceremony will be addressed in more detail later on, it would be remiss of me not to address or not to mention the thanks that we have to give to everyone who made this day possible and who made the journey of the class of 2023 a success. The purchasing of awards, the numerous calls to sponsors, the creation of all invitations, certificates, distribution of gowns, organizing of rehearsals, speeches, refreshments, the ushers, form fours who came in to assist to ensure the sustainability, the choir, the dancers, the decor. Oh my, the decor. This beehive of activity is active, and the honey which we produce is of the best quality. SCSS dares to be different. SCSS always dares to take up a challenge. We will forever advocate for the collaborative efforts of the policymakers, parents, and the corporate society to ensure that we evolve positively. What our theme requires of us today is tantamount to our motto. As we collectively say it for the last time, let us affirm always to carry on beyond the walls of SCSS our motto, which is? I did not hear you. Let us carry on to always be steadfast in work and example. Thank you and congratulations to our graduates.
You don't sound like you believe it, so I'm going to do it again. Do you believe that SCSS is the best? Yes. Her speech was long, but what made it long? Our achievements. It made it long. And thank you, Ms. Combi, for highlighting all that which we achieved in the last school year. And those of you sitting in front of me, graduates, you are making history as well. You are adding to the statistics of the best school on the island.
From sports to academics, all we can see is greatness. But indeed, if for a second you see me looking to that side a little bit more, it's because I've never seen our young men look so handsome before. So, special applause to our young men.
Indeed, at this time I would like to say a special welcome, a special shout out to Mr. Edmund the Great. He's in our midst. Let's put our hands together for Mr. Edmund, former teacher at the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School.
And as we proceed, we'll call on Tonya, Miss Tonya Descat, as she does a special feature.
Do Journey Through 5 Years, A Secondary School Odyssey. In a realm of numbers, letters and facts, a labyrinth of deadlines, papers and stacks, books and exams, a ceaseless tide, a moment to unwind as stress subsides. Mountains of tasks forever in pursuit, unyielding efforts aiming to astute. Whispers in classrooms, anxious hearts confess, stories untold or perhaps laid to rest. Pressure mounts, expectations ascend, yet within our heart, serenity will mend. Test and assessment, a relentless grind, anxiety grips, seeking solace we find. Embrace the challenges, learn and evolve, release the fear of failure that may dissolve. For schooling's a chapter in life's grand tale, a stepping stone where futures prevail, where friendship bloom or perhaps erode, while others fade like whispers in the breeze. Some bonds grow strong like sturdy oak trees, but friendships change as time goes by. Some sound flourish while others say goodbye. Amidst the chaos, a flicker of light, teachers as beacons shining with might. Friends lending hand in this demanding land, together we traverse, united we stand. Knowledge and growth, battles worth the fight, through it all we'll illuminate with might. And as the final chapter unfolds its embrace, our 5-year odyssey reaches its place. We stand together, united and strong, reflecting on the years that passed along, secondary school, where memories reside with laughter, tears, and moments we confide. Lessons learned both inside and outside the class, shaping our futures as the time comes to pass. In friendships forged and knowledge gained, a foundation built forever sustained, we step into the world with head held high, equipped with dreams that reach the sky. With gratitude, we bide our school's ado, the lessons we cherish, the friendships so true. Secondary school, a chapter now complete, but its impact on us will forever repeat. And as we embarked on new paths, far and near, we carry the spirit of these years so dear.
Thank you, Tonya, for this wonderful performance. A round of applause again for Tonya.
At this moment, we pause to acknowledge our sponsors. Without you, today's graduation ceremony would not have been a success. And to those of us who are here who wish to contribute or to join the sponsors list next year, please reach out to somebody from Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School. The little that you have will go a long way in making this ceremony what it should be for the hardworking students and staff of Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School. So permit us to read the list of sponsors. We have Bank of St. Lucia Limited,
Soufriere Regional Development Foundation,
Fonds Saint-Jacques Credit Union,
Sugar Beach, a Viceroy Resort,
The Beacon Restaurant,
Fedos Restaurant,
Excelsior Plaza,
Total Healthcare Pharmacy.
A rich, full-blown, delectable 5-year SCSS experience. Just when you were about to relieve the lost years, when things seemed to have returned to normalcy, you were forced into the CXE years and amateurishly had to settle quickly when you still wanted to play. Think futuristically when you're still searching for you in the present. Work hard to make the recommended list. There was no time to regain or reclaim years lost. This was your reality, but it is an interesting experience worth retelling 40 years later, one where you were able to triumph against all odds. Then there is the ignominious D-block failure that you will never get a chance to inhabit. Previously, your principal and now your education officer, I am fully aware of your needs. And though I tried to lobby for improved conditions and more resources for you, let's make the excuse that if I coulda, I woulda. Like I coulda build you a state-of-the-art school with all the technology
technological accoutrements and a curriculum so diverse and effective to denote real 21st century education. But hey, even in horrendous, deplorable, repulsive conditions, SCSS performs brilliantly. It tells of the collective intellectual strength and degree of resiliency that define you. The greatness that lies therein in spite of the tattered physical appearance. This is the same attitude I want you students to exemplify as you move on. Do not allow your circumstances to define or stunt your growth. Rise, rise, rise above your situations and defeats. Transform into the best you the world would ever see. I remember you, students. I once saw you as very gullible, childish, playful students in the lower forms who have now matured so beautifully to young adults and ready to take up your spots in the world. Note that I said world, because there needs to be a shift, an evolution of your thought and behavior, that the world is yours. You are no longer constrained by territorial boundaries. The skills and qualifications that you will possess can transport you far and wide. Do not limit your thinking to what is narrowly available here in St. Lucia. There is so much untapped possibilities within you and dreams ready to be born. I want you to whisk that yoke out of you so that your inner core, your essential attribute, is exposed and put to great use. You have been well manured at SCSS with the knowledge and skills, irrigated with the requisite values to become productive global citizens. The onus is on you to continue developing yourself post SCSS. We want to see, hear, and celebrate you as you leave footprints of success wherever you roam. Your greatest human adventure is the evolution of consciousness. In this vast universe, your life is likened to a blip captured through a heart monitor. You are here and then quickly snatched before you have lived fully or achieved much. We witness countless examples of this, my own life story, and what just happened on the weekend in Denry. Youth with so much potential and exciting plans for their future, and their lives just gone, just like that, in the rush of a wind. So in that blip, graduates, make a conscious effort to be a star. Shine every day, every time, while you are here. So congratulations on reaching this milestone in your life. And the bestest wishes and blessings upon you as you tarry on. Godspeed, and may his favor find you.
We thank Ms. Joelle Charlemagne for this great, for this excellent feature. Do not let your circumstance define your success, but go. You have been given knowledge. Go. The world is ours. Ms. Joelle Charlemagne, we thank you. We at this point would like to recognize our gold sponsor.
Our platinum sponsor, Anshasne Jade Mountain. Anshasne Jade Mountain has been consistent. They have been our biggest sponsor for our graduation for many, many years. No organization or institution have been able to outdo them. And we also want to acknowledge Mr. Peter Japol, the representative for Anshasne Jade Mountain. So students, I would like you to Help me thank Anshasne Jade Mountain. I'm going to say thank you. The girls are going to say Anshasne, and the boys are going to say Jade Mountain. Okay? You ready? Let's go. Thank you. Indeed, Mr. Jepal, thank you so very much for all that Anshasne Jade Mountain is doing. At this time, we invite our parliamentary representative, Honorable Emma Hippolyte, to deliver her address. Let's put our hands together for our district rep.
Mrs. Joelle Shalmine, our district education officer, Ms. Combi, our principal, teachers, parents, our guest speaker, Ms. Solomon, graduates, I want to recognize in a special way Mr. Peter Chapal, who is the rep for Anshasne Jade Mountain. Esteemed ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I bring you greetings from the Honorable Prime Minister and the members of Cabinet, especially your Minister for Education, Honorable Sean Edwards, who would really like to be present here today, but is representing your country overseas. I want to thank the school for giving me this opportunity to say a few words to you graduates. As someone who did my primary and high school in Soufriere, I am truly honored to be here to celebrate with you today. This proves that our instruction in Soufriere is just as good as the city schools. Except here in Soufriere, we know you by name. There is a greater sense of community. People also know your parents and will not hesitate to scold or discipline you or tell you when you have gone astray. Based on your achievements as outlined by your principal today, there is much to celebrate. It is important that we reflect on areas for improvement, but we must take and make the necessary time to celebrate good work. As I listen to the principal as she outlined your various achievements, I felt very proud of you graduating class, and I want you to give yourself a round of applause. As you embark on a new journey, it is important to maintain focus and discipline. Never lose sight of your why. I cannot underscore enough the importance of self-image, self-awareness, self-esteem, and self-actualization, particularly at this impressionable stage in your life, when the opinion opinion of your peers threaten to outweigh the lessons and principles taught by your parents and your teachers. Negative self-talk and poor self-image can derail even the greatest among us. How you see yourself can determine the extent of your growth. I want to tell you today that as a girl who grew up in this Soufriere community, helping my parents in this shop over there and on the farm, before and after school, is proof that how you start off on life's journey is no guarantee on how you finish. I am one who people had reservations about. People dismissed my potential because of my upbringing and the fact that I didn't have the shine or the gloss of the city girl. When I look back on my life, I was as simple and unassuming as it comes. My parents would not have tolerated anything else. I wasn't ashamed or embarrassed by my humble circumstances. Even at your age, I knew it was only a matter of time before I broke the mold of what was expected of me as someone who came from humble beginnings. I knew that I was extremely good at mathematics and later discovered that I enjoyed accounting. And I pursued both relentlessly. When I graduated from the Sir Lewis Community College secretarial program, I knew that I had only scratched the surface of my potential. And while I love serving my employers in this clerical capacity, I knew there was much more I could contribute. As delusionary as it sounds, I knew that I could have a greater impact in being a decision maker. Today, I am extremely grateful for that determination and passion, as they carried me a long way in this lifetime. I am equally appreciative of the fact that I grew up in this community and got to experience the fullness and richness of a childhood full of color and adventure. Had I listened to those dissenting negative voices who sought to limit my progress and constantly remind me of where I came from, I assure you that I would not be speaking with you today. Sometimes it is good to be silent and just let the people talk. You first need to know yourself. Resist distraction and maintain an unwavering focus on what truly matters. Your goals. That is what matters. As we as a government seek to minimize mismatch of skill sets, we cannot help but acknowledge the world is evolving and our youth, you, are more focused on jobs that are less labor intensive. In other words, you are more committed to working smart not hard in the literal sense. Remember, there is a time and a place for everything. A time for work, a time for rest, a time for play. None more important than the other. Even at your young age, idle time should be minimized. Although there is a place for it, it is important to keep that young mind actively engaged in positive endeavors. As you embark on this new journey, I urge you to seek wholesome mentors and cement your place in this world. It is very important that you choose your companies, the persons who give you advice. This is very important. Never lose sight of the future you, because circumstances are bound to change with time and effort. Always remain focused on what it is you want to be. So, graduates, let no one define your destiny. Dream big. For Michelle Obama said, it is absolutely still possible to make a difference. You can make it. Remember the school motto that you just recited earlier, which sounds like steadfast in work and example. With this, I want to join the other speakers before me in wishing you the very best on life's journey. May God guide you.
I'm just noticing how short I am. I don't have heels. See yourself in a positive light. Let people talk and focus on your goals. Dream big. I almost said thank you, Auntie Emma. But thank you, the Honorable Miss Emma Hippolyte, for this wonderful, inspiring feature. As we continue this graduation, they say all good things must come to an end, but I don't want it to come to an end. But as we continue, we call now on Mistress Vertilia Pascal as she does the presentation of certificates.
All the persons involved in presenting the certificates, please join me to the front. Also, I would like Mrs. Munger to join me up front. Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and good afternoon to my very beautiful young ladies and handsome gentlemen. I will begin with my pretty ladies. Janaya Modest. Janaya is graduating today with a pass in English A that she wrote in Form 4. Nalisha Mitchell. Brianna Nelson. Chevelle Phillip. Tina Esnad. Katie Gills. Zion Alcindor. She's graduating with a CXC pass in EDPM, written in Form 4. She also receives a certificate for peer helper. Katie Matthew. Katie also receives a certificate for senior prefect. Gracie Edward. Denisha Valton. Salin Fosua. Salin is graduating today with a pass in Mathematics, EDPM, and English A that she wrote in Form 4. She also receives a certificate for peer helper, music, and senior prefect. Ruth Mukete. Ruth is graduating today with a pass in English A that she wrote in Form 4. Lovely Son. Alani Prospect. Alani is graduating today with a pass in Mathematics, EDPM, and English A that she wrote in Form 4. She receives a certificate for Students Council, Peer Helpers, Senior Prefects, and Music. Kimali Didier. Kimali is graduating today with a pass in EDPM and English A that she wrote in Form 4. Simonia Elvik. Tiana Charmine. Tiana is graduating today with a pass in EDPM, Biology, Maths, and English A that she wrote in Form 4. She also receives a certificate or certificates for Cadets, Music, Senior Prefect, Students Council, and Peer Helper. Ashla Clements.
Ashla.
Ella Alexander. Thank you. Chriselle Alsey. Tonya Descartes. Tonya is graduating today with a pass in EDPM and mathematics that she wrote in Form 4. She also receives a certificate for peer helper, music, senior prefect, and students council. Kiana Alcendor. Shamaka Lawrence. Shamaka is graduating today with a pass in mathematics that she wrote in Form 3. She's also graduating with CXC passes in biology, EDPM, and English A written in Form 4. She also receives certificates for cadets, senior prefects, peer helper, and students council. Melanie George. Savannah Nestor. Savannah also receives a certificate for a senior prefect. Cadelia Paul. Cadelia is graduating today with a pass in EDPM and English A that she wrote in Form 4. You tell Cartil. No. Brittany Edward. Kiana Nelson. Eva Francis. Precious Nicholas. Precious is graduating today with a pass in English A that she wrote in Form 4. Tanisha Michelle. Amanda Antoine. Kalani Alsi. Kalani is graduating with a CXC pass in mathematics, written in Form 4. Daisy Osman. Nicole Jabatis. Shanika Antoine. Desley Elizy. Desley is graduating today with a pass in French and English A that she wrote in Form 4. She also receives a certificate for peer helper and senior prefect. Geneva James. Geneva is graduating today with a pass in EDPM that she wrote in Form 4. Heading over to my handsome young man. Dwayne Fildress.
the Silver Cadet. Our own miracle child, Mikhail Hippolyte. Elijah Nestor. Veron Philippi. Veron also receives a certificate for cadets. Kurt Kalix. Kurt is graduating today with a pass in EDPM that he wrote in Form 3, as well as passes in English A and Mathematics that he wrote in Form 4. He also receives a certificate for Senior Prefect. Simonus Felix. Nove Leo. Nove is graduating today with a pass in EDPM that he wrote in Form 4. He also receives a certificate for music, cadet, peer helper, and senior prefect. Jaden Amidi. Jaden also receives a certificate for cadet. Jordan Amidi. Jordan also receives a certificate for cadet and senior prefect. Mikhaili Clovis. Mikhaili also receives a certificate for peer helper and cadet. Nkosi Devay. Garrick Johnny. Herb Carrasco. Dravid Andrew. Kyron Purpy. Kyron is graduating with a CXC pass in EDPM that he wrote in Form 3, as well as a pass in OA that he wrote in Form 4. Darian Maslin. Darian also receives a certificate for senior prefect. Wayne Filgens. Karel Prevo. Peter Lansico. Jalen Maslin. Nolan George. Nolan also receives a certificate for peer helper. Burnley Montut. And we already know who is next. Dante Prosper. Manish, yeah, we. Manish also received a certificate.
for senior prefects.
Our next Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, Malik Dennis. Malik also receives a certificate for senior prefects. Dill William. Kenias Kazibo. Kenias also receives a certificate for senior prefect. Destin Elizee. Destin is graduating today with a pass in French and English A that he wrote in Form 4. He also receives a certificate for a senior prefect. Thalys Shalui. Victor Mangru. Victor is graduating today with 3 CXC passes in EDPM, English A, and OA. He wrote EDPM in Form 3 and English A and OA in Form 4. He also receives a certificate for senior prefect. And you know, if there is Dante, expect them to be a last prospect. Thank you so much, Mrs. Vanguru.
Thank you, Mrs. Pascal and Ms. Mongru, and also the teachers who assisted in the distribution of the certificates.
I enjoyed this presentation, Miss.
Indeed.
We now move on to a special part of our procession. Do you know what time it is? It's not just 2:58. It's time for the graduates to sing the last song together. We call now on the graduates for Miss Ferguson for what?
For their rendition. Let's put our hands together, parents, for our graduates as they sing to us this afternoon.
Hold on.
We ask the graduates to sit. SCSS! DJ, still actor, run it again. A better tomorrow, run it again. Not yet. Thank the students, the graduates, for this wonderful performance. I even heard and saw Simon sing. Thank you for this wonderful performance. Next, we have a special person coming up. And I don't think that I could have the privilege of introducing this person. Miss Ferguson?
Sure. Our guest speaker was born and raised in Sulphur Springs, Soufriere. She completed her elementary and secondary school education in her hometown, attending the Fossé Jacques Primary School and the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School, respectively. Her academic prowess began at a young age, and she graduated as the valedictorian of Fossé Jacques Primary. In 2014, she was enrolled as a student at the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School. She describes her tenure there as the most transformative experience she has had to date. At the SCSS, she dedicated her time to being a holistic individual, and so she became active in Students' Council and the Junior Achievers Clubs. She also served as head prefect and president of the Pair Helpers Club. Although not an athlete, she was usually one of the highlights of every sporting event. Perhaps she was most renowned for her unique ability at scoring the last place in every race. Her resolute, however, ensured that Toussaint would always be given 1 point. This display of school spirit was the reason why she was named the valedictorian of the class of 2019 of the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School. After she graduated from SCSS, she advanced to the Sir Arthur Lewis Community College. There, she showcased her academic excellence again, graduating on the Dean's List with an associate degree in travel and tourism. Soon after graduating, she became enrolled with the Ministry of Education and holds a teaching position at the Fossé Jacques Primary School. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the guest speaker for the moment, Miss Safia Solomon. Let's put our hands together for Miss Safia Solomon.
Protocol already established. To all those in attendance, I wish you a delightful afternoon. Class of 2023, a specially spiced good afternoon to you. We are gathered here to recognize and celebrate the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School's Class of 23 with distinction, greatness, and prestige. Sadly, many of your friends who entered the gates of SCSS 5 years ago were not fortunate to be here today for some reason or the other. You have made it to the end, so there is much to be proud of. Give yourselves a round of applause. The last time I stood before an audience of this magnitude was to address my very own class as valedictorian. So I feel honored indeed to be here before you as your guest speaker under the theme Real World Readiness. An evolution of thought and behavior. A theme aptly chosen for you, as COVID-19 has caused a shift in the manner in which things were done in the past. Real-world readiness, often referred to as global readiness, is the buzzword for businesses, colleges, and universities. It simply means the acquisition of skills
that you will need to engage across borders and enhancing your adaptability to respond to those demands, whether it be in the workplace or in an institution of higher learning. The Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School has provided you the avenue to allow yourself to be groomed for that real world. You were nurtured, protected, guided, some against your own will, all in an effort to be able to stand on your own and to be the best that you could be. I have been there, so I know the values, rules, and disciplines that persons like Mr. Jude, Mr. Charles, and Ms. Combi, among others, tried vehemently to instill in you, just to adequately to prepare you for the real world. As of today, you are no longer confined to the walls of SCSS. In the real world, you must be able to adjust and respond effectively to an unpredictable environment. The process by which you do this will continuously change with every given circumstance. However, there are some universal expectations which I wish to share with you today. You are like beautiful butterflies ready to explore your world, a world where growth and change are happening at a remarkable pace. Persons who do not embrace learning new things will be left behind. The school gave you the knowledge, skills, and attitude, but nothing you learned is static. The attitude that we've always done it this way or the teacher taught it that way can no longer hold. Mindset change is paramount to deal with the adaptation of new norms, be it on the job, higher education, or life in general. Carol Dweck, in her book, Mindset, The New Psychology of Success, shows how success in school, work, sports, the arts, and almost every area of human endeavor can be dramatically influenced by how we think about our talent and abilities. People with fixed mindsets, those who believe abilities are fixed, are less likely to flourish than those with growth mindset, those who believe that abilities can be developed. A growth mindset can enable you to demonstrate continued development through perseverance and determination. Sometimes all it takes is a little change in your routine, thus bringing out the creativity in you. A mindset change combined with dedication to continuous learning and developing oneself will ensure you are prepared to face any change or challenges. 2 years ago, while we were battling the COVID crisis, many of you dreaded the idea of online learning. For some of you, continuing education may very well be online in the near or distant future. The new norm is that many persons continue their education without ever seeing a classroom. Others continue to work in a virtual setting. Whether physical or virtual, there will be need for proper time management. You will need to stay on task to get your work done without anyone looking over your shoulder. Soft skills like effective communication, taking initiative, and decision making are essential skills that will continue to evolve and in some instances, rapidly. The cell phones which you have right now may very well become obsolete in the next year or so. As technology evolves, persons are finding new ways to use it. Social and digital media is running the show these days, though you still need to be cognizant of what's out there, how it works, and the audience it caters to. Keep in mind that the audience includes not only young persons like yourselves, but employers scouting for the new employees are also there to see if you are the right fit for the job. We are living in a society where things are changing rapidly. It calls on you to evaluate yourselves in the light of the current state of our community and the world. The sum of your 5 years at SCSS made you the young men and women seated in front of me today. I am sure for many of you, those 5 years were the worst and best years of your life thus far. However, the experience you have gathered allowed you to learn things about yourselves and life in general. That which you have experienced gave you clarity, You were able to learn right from wrong in difficult situations and the wisdom to take a divergent path when and if needed. Now you go to face the future, and I pray it is filled with an abundance of love, joy, wonder, opportunities. The list is endless. Many of you, I am sure, are absolutely fascinated and terrified at the same time by not knowing what will happen next. I wonder how many of you are eager and ready to paint the vision you have for your lives, or perhaps you are sharpening your wit and skills, ready for the labor force, or pursuing higher education. Whatever the case, you are in control of your future. Whatever happens, it's on you. With that, I encourage you to be fully present in the moment, despite how insignificant they may seem. Make the memories that will give you stories to tell. Do not wait for the perfect opportunity to come. Go out and find it, and do it all with an attitude of readiness. Where do you want to be in the next 5 years of your life? What do you want to achieve? Changes come and go, and so too can your thoughts on your goals for your future. Remain focused. It is closer than you think. I'd like to share two lessons that I've learned which has helped me carve out my life. Firstly, be patient and try again. Achieving a goal, whether short-term or long-term, may take longer than expected. Life is unpredictable, and patience is a key factor in gaining success. You may hit walls throughout your life and feel like you're never going to make it, but don't lose hope and don't be discouraged. Sometimes the worst tasting medicines are often the best. Secondly, think things through before you make any decisions. Don't be hasty or impulsive, because that can impact the rest of your life. Be conscious of your surroundings and think about how your decision could affect it. Try to decipher patterns and make sense of difficult situations. Life is not going to be a walk in the park, but I believe it is important to have role models to uplift you. Class of 23, I encourage you to find people in your life that support you, stimulate you with meaningful conversations, and aren't afraid to tell you when you are doing something wrong. I encourage you to take chances and expose yourself to new experiences. The choices you make in your life will ultimately determine your future. All in all, the words I have spoken are just that, words, which most of you will forget by the night's end. My hope is that they will come back to you when you need a boost or when you're reminiscing about this day. For the real test is putting those words into action. Take it day by day. Focus on progress, not perfection. Thank you so much for listening. I truly appreciate the opportunity which was afforded me to be here today with you. May God bless us all. Thank you.
Sophia, we're inviting you to stay close, very close. We now call on Ms. Lani Prosper to give the token to the guest speaker. I hope you, like me, listen to every word that was said. Be patient with your development of character and know that your choices now will predict your future. Proceeding with this graduation, we will have a special performance. A very special performance.
us down. But look at where we are now. Don't think that the test is done. The journey has just begun. The best is yet to come. Believe and say yes you can. If you can dream it, you also can live it. You must believe it if you want to be it. Everybody know that you can complete it. Definitely work hard, you will achieve it. Fear it will visit, but please do not reach it. You not a frog that will hop and say ribbit. Stop acting weak like you soft like a kick it. You are a rock, lion.
Look who we are. We are the dreamers. We make it happen. Look who we are.
Didn't I tell you it was a special performance? Another round of applause for the SCSS choir and dancers. And Jonathan, Lucien, Mr. Kazabo, I heard you. Wonderful singing, wonderful singing. There will be no better introduction for the presentation of awards. There could be no better introduction to award our graduates. We now call on Miss Isis Ale, Miss Nubia Ale, and Miss Courtney John for the presentation of awards.
One, two. All right, thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, students. Can I still say students? Yes, no? After the awards, then I will call you graduates. All right. So at this time, we are here to present the awards. Parents, are you ready for it? Parents, it's your moment as well. Are you ready for it? All right. This afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you assist us in celebrating our stars in various subject areas as we deliver awards worthy to be called Oscars. We hope that this is the beginning of bigger awards for our stars.
At this time, we would like to invite Miss Lorena Wilson to present these awards.
Can the following students please come forward?
Victor Mangru.
Deste Elize.
Desley Elize.
Alani Prosper.
Tiana Shalmine.
Darian Masley.
Ruth Mukete.
Vernly Montout.
Kimali Didier.
Kurt Kalix.
Shamaka Lawrence.
And Kalani Alsi. The Eldridge Thomas English Language Award. Put your hands together for Victor Mangaro.
Special awards for English. Deste Elize.
Alani Prosper.
Darian Masley,
Vernley Montoot,
Desley Elize,
Tiana Shalmine,
and Ruth Muketi.
The English Literature Award, Desley Elize.
Special award for English literature goes to Ruth Muketi.
The Spanish award, Deste Elize.
Award for Spanish is awarded to none other than his twin sister, Desley Elize.
French award, Desley Elize.
And a special award for French goes to none other than her twin brother, Deste Elize.
Another special award for French, Kimali Didier.
The award for mathematics goes to Desley Elize.
Special award for mathematics, good colleagues.
Shamaka Lawrence also receives a special award for mathematics.
Kalani Alsi, special award for mathematics.
Alani Prosper also receives a special award for mathematics.
Thank you, Ms. Wilson. Put your hands together for her. At this time, we'd like to invite Mr. Japol, the representative of Anshasne Jade Mountain, to present the following awards.
Can the following students please come forward? Alani Prosper.
Victor Manguru.
Desley Elize.
Ruth Mukete.
Precious Nicholas.
The Agricultural Science Single Award, Victor Manguru.
The award for biology goes to none other than Alani Prospect.
The Chemistry Award, Ruth Mukete.
The Special Award for Chemistry goes to Alani Prospect.
Alani also receives the award for Physics. Put your hands together for her.
Special award for physics goes to Victor Mangu.
The Social Studies Award, Desley Elize.
The Special Award for Social Studies, Ruth Mukete.
Special award for social studies, Precious Nicholas.
Thank you, Mr. Jean-Paul. I would like to invite the acting vice principal, Mr. Zayel Williams, to present the following awards.
Can the following students please step forward?
Desley Elize.
Alani Prosper.
Darian Masle.
Kimali Didier.
Precious Nicholas.
Victor Manguru.
Tonya Descott.
The Principal of Accounts Award goes to Desley Elize.
The Special Award for Principals of Accounts goes to Alani Prosper.
The Principal of Business Award, Desley Elize.
Award for Principals of Business goes to Kimali Didier.
Another special award for Principals of Business, Mr. Maslin.
The award for office administration goes to Precious Nicholas.
The information technology award, Victor Manguru.
Special award for information technology goes to Darian Masley.
The EDPM award, Tonya Descott.
Thank you, Mr. Williams. Presently, I wish to invite the representative from Sugar Beach to present the following awards.
Can the vice principal come forward? Okay, Ms. Kwambi, can you come forward? Thank you. Can the following students please come forward?
Nicole George,
Desley Elize,
Stalin Faswa,
Victor Mangu,
Vernley Montut,
Hervé Carrasco,
Dante Prosper,
Kimali Didier,
Kalani Alse,
Kurt Carlix.
The award for food and nutrition goes to Desley Elize.
Special award for food and nutrition, Ruth Mukete.
Prosper also receives a special award for food and nutrition.
The award for pastry and cake decorating, Stalin Faswa.
The award for geography goes to none other than Victor Mangu.
The technical drawing award, put your hands together, Vernley Montut.
The award for building technology goes to Hervé Carrasco.
Special award for building technology, Dante Prosper.
Award for history goes to Desley Elize.
Kalani Alse receives the award for economics.
Special award for economics goes to Kimali Didier.
Physical education, who do you think it is? Kurt Kalix.
For visual arts goes to none other than Mr. Vernley Montut.
The Music Award. Neve Leon. Yeah! Thank you, Ms. Combi.
I wish to invite Mr. Theodale to give out the Aptitude for Science Awards.
This award is given to two students who have shown exceptional performance in practical science and experiments, as well as overall interest. This award is sponsored by Theodale's Electrical Services. Put your hands together for Mr. Theodale. And this award goes to
Alani Prosper
and Victor Mangu. Thank you so very much. Thank you, sir. At this point, I would like to call on the District Education Officer, Mrs. Shalmine, to assist us with the following awards. Can the following students please step forward?
Makaili Clovis.
Katie Gills.
Eva Francis.
Utelka Taylor.
Shanika Antoine.
Dante Prosper.
Neve Leo.
We are moving on to the CVQ Awards. The award for auto mechanics goes to Makaili Clovis.
Makaili Clovis also receives the award for furniture making.
Garment construction, Katie Gills.
The award for fabric design goes to Eva Francis.
Pastry and cake making, Utelka Taylor.
The special award for pastry and cake making goes to Shanika Antoine.
General construction, Dante Prosper.
Special award for general construction goes to Neve Leo.
Thank you, Mr. Shalmine. Can Mr. Vincent Jean-Philippe come forward?
Ladies and gentlemen, we would like at this juncture to honor our sporting stars. Can the following students please come forward? Denisha Valton, Jenny James, Daisy Osman, Utelka Taylor, Lovely Son, Dravid Andrew, Kurt Calix, Malik Dennis, Manish Pielui, and Lance Prosper. I wish to invite one of the coaches of the netball team, Mrs. Melita Hippolyte, to present the award for top netballer.
All right, and who do you think receives this award today? Our top netballer award. Who is it? Good try. Who else? Put your hands together for our top netballer.
Miss Denisha Fulton. I would now like to call on Mr. Marc Antoine, the head of the sports department, to present the following awards.
Thank you, Mrs. Hippolyte.
The award for female basketballer of the year, none other than, put your hands together for Janine
James.
James. And our female volleyballer, none other than Daisy Osman. We now move to our track stars. Our track and field stars, we have two persons sharing the spotlight. Please help me welcome Utelka Taylor and Denisha Bolton. We also have a special award for track, and this goes to Lovely Song. We now move to the males, and our male footballer of the year.
Let me hear you say.
2023.
Kurt Kallex.
Mr. Kurt Kallex. Dangerous with ball in hand. Our cricketer of the year, the man, Travid Andrew. Blazing our tracks, male track star of the year 2023. Please get up again, sir, Mr. Kurt Kallex. Yes, sir. Formidable young man on the track. I am
not
obliged.
And he's from the Rodney House.
All right, and the field events, we have tall and strong, the young man, Mr. Lance Prosper. I think I can see he's from Rodney as well. No, stop it, please. All right, and basketball, our basketball star 2023, Mr.
Malik Dennis.
And our volleyball star, the man himself, Mr. Manish Pialui. And to bring down the curtains in these awards, we have a table tennis award which goes to Mr. Kurt Kallex. Yes, indeed.
Thank you, Mr. Antoine. Thank you.
The sports committee would like to recognize two young ladies for their willingness to assist whenever called upon to prepare delicious meals for our athletes and the sports department.
And I'm going to call on Mr. Vincent Jean-Philippe to assist us with these awards. Thank you, sir. These two young ladies, put your hands together for them, Kiana Alcendor and Cassel Alce. They receive a voucher sponsored by Corsules. Cassel also receives a voucher sponsored by M&C Drugstore. Put your hands together for these two young ladies. Thank you so very much for your contribution towards the sports department. And Mrs. Ferguson wants me to let you know that Kiana is from the Rodney House.
At this moment, I would like to call on the assistant house master for Ira, Mrs. Jemma Bob, to present a few awards.
Put your hands together for Miss Bob. We are moving to the house awards, and let me hear you say, yeah, yeah, for Ira. Thank you very much. This is my house, the best house.
And these are some awards for deserving stars for the commitment and outstanding contribution to the Ira House throughout their tenure at Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School.
Karel Prevost.
Malik Dennis.
Ruth Mukete.
Genevieve James.
Stalin Fassois.
Zion Alcindor.
And Kyron Puppy.
At this point, I would like to invite the Rodney House Assistant Housemaster, Mrs. Ferguson, to present.
Thank you, Mrs. Bob. Thank you.
Some special awards
to the Ira House. Thank you.
To the deserving stars from the Rodney House for the contribution and the commitment throughout their tenure at the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School.
Let me just inform you that, I mean, Rodney comes second in place for me. I was actually a student of the Rodney House, Mr. Edmund. Mr. Edmund forced me to run all sorts of races, right, Mr. Edmund? So put your hands together for the Rodney House.
All right, we will call on the girls first of all. Kalani Alse. Rodney is the best house. Thank you,
Kiana Alcendor.
Desley Elize.
Janaya Modest.
And we have Nalisha Mitchell. Always, always ready to run. We move to the boys after.
Thank you.
And in the boys category for the Rodney House, we have
Jordan Amity. And I feel so proud to call on this individual, Simonus Felix. Put your hands together for him.
One of the hardest working members there, always ready to run. Yes, man. And we have Darian Masner. Lance Prosper.
Kurt Kalex.
Manus Pialui. And Carlis Shalwi.
Thank you, Mrs. Ferguson.
And at this time, I would like to invite the clockhouse master, Miss Noel, to present some special awards to the deserving stars of the clockhouse for their outstanding contribution and the commitment to the clockhouse throughout their tenure at the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School. She is represented by Miss Yoshabel Emmanuel,
who is in a red dress, and I mean, come on, Mrs. Emmanuel, not today.
All right, let's call on the athletes. Ella Alexander.
Denisha Valton.
Daisy Osman.
Simonia Elivik.
Dante Prosper.
Deste Elize.
At this point, please permit me to call on Mr. Theodil, who is the housemaster for Toussaint, to present the awards for the Toussaint athletes for their contribution towards the 5 years at the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School. And for those who do not know, Toussaint is the greenhouse. We call upon Travis Andrew. Make some noise as the young man comes through.
Lovely Son.
Utelka Taylor.
Tonya Descartes. Woo!
Nicole Jabatis.
And Ashla Clement. The Tuse House would also like to recognize the Tuse cheerleaders for their hard work, resilience, and determination. And these awards are sponsored by Tuts School Supplies. Put your hands together for Miss Tutelier. Call it on. The cheerleaders award. Tina Esnad.
Nicole Jabatis.
Tonya Descott.
And Brianna Nelson.
Do we have a representative from Bank of St. Lucia? Thank you, Mr. Fiodil. I'd like to now call on Mr. Marc Antoine, head of the sports department, to present the final two awards. Our Sportsman and Sportswoman awards were sponsored by Bank of St. Lucia Limited. Put your hands together for BOSL, all the bank you need.
All right, and we now move to the Sportsman. Sportsman of the Year. The Sportsman of the Year is a versatile athlete. He participated in the inter-schools championships throughout his tenure, and he also represented his house, the Walter Rodney House, in football, table tennis, volleyball, and track and field events. He dominated the inter-house road race and the inter-school secondary school road race. He was an exceptional middle distance runner who won gold at the inter-secondary school championships. As a member of the national football team, he represented the island at both the under 15 and under 17 categories, winning gold for St. Lucia at the Pride of the Caribbean Invitational Tournament in 2023. Ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together for a great beacon of the Walter Rodney House and a star of SCSS, our Sportsman of the Year, Mr. Kurt Collins.
She wants me to say to my Ira people, Rodney.
Yeah, yeah. Yes, indeed. As he moves forward in his sporting prowess. And we move over to the Sportswoman of the Year. Our Sportswoman of the Year participated diligently in every sporting endeavor which she undertook. At the inter-house level, she represented and emerged winner of the school's road race twice. She dominated the long distance races during sports meets and performed exceptionally well at inter-secondary school track meets, winning gold and silver medals at events she entered. To the school's netball team, she was an invaluable member, contributing in a large measure to the many titles won. Naturally, she was called up for training for the national netball team. We expect much from her at the national level. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for one of the shining stars of the Frederick Clark House, and our 2023 Sportswoman of the Year,
Ms. Denisha
Alton.
Thank you so very much, Mr. Benson Shuffley. Put your hands together for him. Thank you, Mr. Antoine. We are moving on. We are almost done to the Top Achievers Awards. At this point, we'd like to present awards to our stars in the following categories. Can the following students come forward? Tiana Shalmine.
Neve Leo.
Dante Prosper.
Alani Prosper.
And Victor Mangu.
I wish to invite Mr. Kendall Alexander, coordinator of the Pair Helpers program, to present the award for Top Pair Helper. I would like to call on Mrs. Kelly to assist us with presenting the Top Pair Helper award.
And the Top Pair Helper award goes to Tiana Shalmine.
The L'Esprit d'École. Now I would like to invite Ms. Combi to present the Principal's Award, L'Esprit d'École. This award is bestowed onto the student who exemplifies school spirit through contribution to school life, academic, and disciplinary excellence. And the award for L'Esprit d'École goes to none other than
Alani Prosper. Can you remain? Thank you, Ms. Combi. Special Contribution to School Life Awards. We have two special contributions here. The first student, the first award was created to honor a student who showed great excellence in leadership. This student led even when they did not hold any leadership title. This award is in appreciation of the helpfulness in coordinating various tasks, whether big or small. And I know you saw him around the school all the time. For a great level of maturity and willingness to serve. Who do you think it is? Put your hands together, and I am proud and super, super, super excited for him, Mr. Neve Leo.
Our second award goes to a student who also exemplifies helpfulness and devotion to all tasks assigned to them. For extensive volunteerism within the general construction projects and being the spark of laughter, humor, and positive vibe in any room. The award goes to none other than Dante Prosper.
Thank you, Ms. Combi. I would now like to call on the representative of our main sponsor and Chasnay Jade Mountain to present the award for the most academic student. This award is conferred on the graduate who has excelled academically and performed at the highest standard throughout his or her studies at SCSS. This student performed exceptionally well for the 5 years at this school, having topped the class and the current form for many terms. This individual attained the highest academic average percentage, the most academic award for 2023 goes to none other than Victor Mangu. Victor also receives a lunch for two at Hotel Chocolat and a monetary contribution towards his tertiary education from the Soufriere Regional Development Foundation. Yeah.
Thank you, Ms. Combi. And Ms. Combi just informed me that he came in as the top student in Form 1 and he's leaving as the top student in Form 1. I would like you to stand and put your hands together for Victor Manguru. Stand, student. Stand, everybody. Thank you.
Award this afternoon in our top achievers category, the most outstanding student award. This student is a charismatic individual who vied for the position of president of the Students Council in November of 2022 and was triumphant. The student became a senior prefect in Form 3 and a head prefect in Form 5. She was also a peer helper, and though she held no executive positions, due to her helpfulness and cheerful spirit, the peer helpers referred to her as their general manager. She joined the cadet corps when she was in Form 2 and remained a diligent cadet ever since. Moving up the ranks throughout the years, she is presently a proud sergeant of the cadet corps. Her willingness to participate in school life and represent the school at any meeting or event made her a reliable individual who would be called upon whenever a student representative was needed from the school. The individual has attended many SCSS graduation ceremonies in the past, as she ensured that she would represent her school in the capacity of an usher. This student obtained 4 CXC subjects in Form 4, namely Mathematics, English A, EDPM, and Biology, achieving a grade 2 in Biology, and making history as the first female student to pursue CVQ auto mechanics in Forms 4 and 5. It is against this background and involvement in school life that this student has been selected as the most outstanding student of the graduating class of 2023. Ladies and gentlemen, graduates, please give Miss Tiana Charlemagne a round of applause. Also receives a monetary contribution towards her tertiary education from SRDF and a voucher from MNC Drugs.
Put your hands together again for our most academic outstanding student for 2023.
Let's give a round of applause to all our awardees this afternoon.
At this point, I'd like to take you back to our MCs.
Such an exciting award ceremony. We thank our sponsors, we thank our staff, and we thank our graduates for this amazing graduation. At this point, we move on to a presentation of award for teachers. She contributed heavily to the food and nutrition department, maintaining a superb pass rate, almost 100% every year. She headed the department and contributed to any activity held by the school. She led the school into national and regional glory at the SLHTA Culinary Arts Competition. This teacher is none other than...
Before you continue, Mr. Fiodil, keep it a secret still. We invite Mrs. Pascal to expand on what you just said. Okay? So keep it still. Don't just say who yet.
We are gathered here today not just to bid a farewell to our lovely students, but to a highly valuable teacher
who has given 13 years of service to the school. Teaching is a profession that creates all other professions, and we are grateful that you chose to be a teacher and that your students have learned so much from you. Mrs. Neshaka Henry, associate degree in food and beverage from South Louis, was an Island Scholar, topped the program at South Louis, and was awarded the Island Scholarship to the University of Johnson and Wales, where she obtained a Bachelor of Science. Mrs. Henry joined the school many years ago and contributed so much time and effort to the students and the school. She has worked tirelessly in shaping the minds and leading students on a good path, and many years have gone by. So it's amazing we don't realize how quickly time flies. Time goes by quickly when you are having a good time. And Mrs. Henry, under your guidance, the student had the best time, and for time well spent, sometimes departures are celebrated more than arrivals. Five of the six local cook-offs that SCSS entered were won by our food and nutrition students, thanks to your leadership. The school cook-off evolved into a local competition. After all, the cook-off idea was your method of inspiring the children. Then, representing St. Lucia like a boss, you and the students went on to make a big splash. And oops, there we go, two-time cook-off champions, regional cook-off champions at that. Let's not forget how passionately and lovingly you teach food and nutrition, which has helped many of our former students succeed in life. You have produced top chefs, pastry chefs, chocolatiers, and the list goes on. We witnessed the emergence of competitions for breakfast platters, dining around the world, where students were required to choose a country and produce a dish native to that country, and not forgetting cupcake wars. You had a great way of motivating your students, and they never wanted to leave your class. So on behalf of fellow students, teachers, and staff, I would like to say a huge thank you to the teacher who taught the students to learn even outside of their classrooms and encourage them to think outside of the box. The teacher is the most influential person in a student's life after their parents, and what a great influence she is for the students to follow. She was a constant source of motivation for everyone in her class. She taught them the importance of valuing and respecting others' knowledge and time. Mrs. Henry always believed in teaching students in a practical world so that they don't forget their way in the real world. She has always celebrated her students' successes as well as their failures by saying, well, you know what not to do. There is no one like you. You are a well-esteemed and very respected teacher. No one will take your place in the lives of your students. And who is going to fill these large shoes? Now it's time to part, and with good wishes and warm regards, we bid you goodbye. Thank you for being the best teacher, mentor, friend, and playing so many roles at the same time. You will surely be missed. There could never be another Neshaka Henry, one of the best food and nutrition teachers in St. Lucia.
A round of applause, students. A round of applause. I am so happy that Miss Pascal gave me the opportunity to do this. Now we call on Miss Joel Charlemagne. Oh my. Oh my. Like the people say, oui mama. So we're very, very disheartened or disheartened to announce that Miss Henry is not with us today. As a result, Miss Pascal will take it on her behalf. So we call now on Miss Joel Charlemagne as she hands the award to Miss Pascal on behalf of Miss Neshaka Henry. A round of applause. Thank you.
just say, no, you can just say we also recognize that we're tiny and stuff like that. Yeah, read it and ask
At this time, we take the opportunity to also recognize one of our retirees, Mr. Octave James. Students, who am I referring to? Mr. Oc, that's the thing, you don't know him as Mr. Octave James. Who knows Mr. Octave James?
Okay, let me help you.
Okay, help me please.
He always adds a bit of sweetness.
Oh, I heard it. Mr. That's how you know him, Mr. Sugar. That's why, Mr. Sugar. Yes, Mr. Octave James, better known as Mr. Sugar. Mr. Octave James began his tenure at SCSS as a relief worker. He became a permanent worker in September of 2011. He lives with many, many memories. We wish Mr. James, aka Mr. Sugar, the best on his retirement. Is he here with us, Mr. Octave James? Are you in the house? Let's put our hands together for Mr. Octave James. Doesn't seem to be here, but we do recognize his valuable contribution to Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School. You'll receive his award at a later date.
So now, to the moment we've all been waiting for. And no, it's not yet vote of thanks or dismissal.
We're almost at the end. Almost.
We now call on the valedictorian for Soufriere Comprehensive 2023. Do you know who this is? I'm hearing yes. I don't think you know who this is. So we now call on Miss Tayana Shalmine, the valedictorian for class of 2023.
Let's put our hands together for Miss Shalmine.
Greetings to all of you who are gathered here today to share in this momentous occasion. As I stand before you, I feel a sense of uneasiness that is quite similar to what I felt when I first entered the gates of the prestigious Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School. I also feel privileged to have been chosen to deliver the valedictory address at this year's graduation. Let me first congratulate my fellow graduates on reaching this milestone. It was definitely not an easy journey. And so, I feel it necessary to reminisce on the challenges which we're confronted with. The global pandemic was one of the main contributors to our challenges at our tenure at SCSS. It created unprecedented changes in our once normal form of school life, which sadly was very short-lived. The COVID-19 pandemic struck us when we were only in Form 2. The virtual world became our new reality. We then had to learn how to navigate our way through the new online learning platform. However, online learning presented many challenges. For example, classes were not easily accessible for those of us who did not own devices or struggled to get reliable internet access. Despite being born into the technological era, for some of us, learning to use the digital platform was still a struggle. However, our teachers ensured that we learned the necessary skills so that we did not stay behind. Nonetheless, some of us enjoyed working from home due to the advantage of being in our pajamas while we attended classes. And not forgetting those of us who would log into the Google Classroom and go right back to bed. For those like me who struggled to adapt because we always identified as a social butterfly, how pleasant was this period for you? The cutback on social interaction had me losing my marbles as I was unable to be myself. The ability to socialize freely were greatly missed. Seeing that we are here today, We did not let the pandemic stop us from continuing this journey. We fought through and we overcame. Despite our challenges, we can all agree that we created memories for our tenure at SCSS. Last year, to celebrate Reading Month, the English department at SCSS gave every form a piece of writing to take the spin on and present to the student body for the elocution activity. The form first got the opportunity to perform the calypso entitled Take Your Meat Out Me Rice by Lord Kitchen. These presentations were definitely something we will never forget. It's simply outstanding how we were able to present the same piece in many different ways. I will certainly not forget how Denisha had the entire school in laughter with her remarkable acting skills in the class performance. It was as though she was indeed replaced with the vision at that moment. Meeting up in the theater's room to have lunch every lunchtime, where conversations wouldn't end until the bell rung. These moments will be greatly missed. I remember our trip to the elderly home and the orphanage where Pay helped us with study baskets. I will sincerely cherish this moment forever. I recall how lucky I felt in this moment. Fortunate enough to have my family members and all the sacrifices they have done for me. On occasions like today, as we all tend to be blinded by the hairstyles, the makeup and the nails, and the new shoes, that we forget what was most important. We forget to acknowledge and appreciate those who never left our side. Those of us who work tirelessly to ensure that we are able to be here today. Parents, teachers, principal, vice principal, and the staff at SCSS, we thank you because we know how challenging it has been. The adolescent years has been described as a period of stress and storm. Indeed, there was a lot of stress and the storms were too many, literally and figuratively. This group of students challenged all that the teachers knew about education. They saw an evolution of thought and behavior, which too often did not coincide with the high expectation they had of administration. The childish games battling with adult behavior were indeed a period of evolution in thought for teachers. My fellow graduates, if we have to be honest, we owe the teachers, the administration, and our parents many thanks for not giving up on us. The parents who were so often present at the school that one would think they applied for a new job. Please continue to support us that we do not understand and appreciate it. The terrible cry for SBAs was something to note. Our petty bickering and fighting for no reason, our suspensions for defying rules which we had no logical reason for breaking, and our lack of effort which we displayed at the most critical times are not commendable. But we shall escape with the excuse of stress and storm. These 5 years recorded significant moments for celebration. We have among us stars in many areas. We have among us some real sporting talents and hopefuls who must be congratulated for trying. Denisha, Journey, Daisy, Ashla, Lovely, Dravid, Kurt, Malik, Manis, and Lentz. We applaud you. Our cheerleaders, especially Dante, also known as Creepy. The main cheerleader was a whole theatrical performance on his own. We did not hesitate to participate in co-curricular activities. Among us are several cadets who were taught the sense of responsibility and leadership. I hope that we have learned and we will implement these. We had choir members who learned the skill of responsibility, being confident, and how to take on the leadership role. Choir reminded me that one should always do what he or she loves and do it to the best of their ability. I'd also like to thank my friends for being there for me and some teachers. My best friend, Shamaka, Kiana, Ashla, Simonia, Denisha, Alani,
Manish, Kurt, Darian, Nerve, Daisy, the whole family group. I'd also like to thank some teachers, Mr. Zhe, not forgetting you. Mr. Zhe used to call my mother phone. I used to be so annoyed, Mr. Zhe used to call my mother phone. But I thank you, Mr. Zhe. Sir Charles, you too. You're not there today? Oh. Sir Charles, you too for giving me that long lecture. I will never forget it. I thank you. The theme for today's ceremony is indeed appropriate for the graduating class of 2023. Let's all repeat after me. Real world readiness, an evolution for thought and behavior. We are at a point where we can initiate change, at a point where we can make a difference. We have been given the skills, we gain the hands-on experience, participated in conflict resolution, broken friendships, broken relationships, and form new ones, which may become lifelong. All of this experience at this stellar institution will definitely contribute to an evolution of thoughts and action. So I leave you with this quote by Norman Vincent Peale this afternoon. When you change your thoughts, remember to change your world. Graduates, I ask that you think about it deeply and you make necessary changes to conquer our world with the skills and experiences gained from our tenure at SCSS. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Charlemagne, for your valedictory address. Students, I hope that you, as you listen and you reminisce on your journey, your five-year journey at SCSS, you will take the good with you and remember the lessons from the bad. At this time, we also want to recognize one more time our sponsors, every single one of them. And don't forget, if you're not part of the sponsors list, please join the sponsors list next year. Our platinum gold sponsor, Anchasne Jade Mountain. Then we have Bank of St. Lucia Limited,
Soufriere Regional Development Foundation,
Fonseja Credit Union,
Sugar Beach, a Viceroy Resort,
The Beacon Restaurant,
and Fedor's Restaurant,
Excelsior Plaza,
Total Healthcare Pharmacy,
Laho Resort,
Auto Specialist,
Baron Foods Limited,
Chosel Credit Union,
St. Lucia Teachers Cooperative Union Limited,
Cool Breeze Service Station,
Soufre Service Station,
Lazarus from your parlor,
Mr. Simeon Casabo,
MNC Limited,
Costulus Boutique,
Winera,
True Value,
Fordo Eco Resort,
Paradise Hotel,
St. Lucia National Lottery,
Crick's Funeral Home,
Mr. Felix Abraham,
Sankofa Creations,
Rumbali's Funeral Parlor,
PG Color Mix,
Massey Stores, St. Lucia,
Forest Springs,
Miss Lorena Wilson,
Soufre Fonseja Constituency Council,
Exciting Tours,
Ben's Taxi Service,
Hotel Chocola,
Bath Agricultural Station,
Photo Express,
Allen's Supermarket,
Ladera Resort,
Sunshine Nails and Spa,
South Shore Service and Limited.
Last but not least, Mr. Ricky James, the administration and staff of Soufre Comprehensive Secondary School, thanks you immensely for your contribution, whether it be through monetary contributions, your support. Let's put our hands together for our sponsors one more time. Thank you, thank you, thank you. At this time, we invite Mr. Victor Mungru to deliver the vote of thanks. Let's put our hands together for him.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. On behalf of the graduating class of 2023, allow me to emphasize that without the direction and instruction of those present today, we would not have been able to achieve what we have today. we must foremostly thank God for all his mercies and blessings that he has bestowed upon us thus far in our journey. We are aware that none of this would have been possible without him. We sincerely thank Pastor Kendall Augustine for his prayers to encourage, uplift, and bless those graduating today. We are grateful to him for commencing this ceremony with such grace and for calling forth the Creator's presence. We would like to thank our Master and Mistress of Ceremonies for involving us and facilitating a seamless flow of activities during the ceremony. We also want to express our gratitude to Mr. Casabo, Donaton, the choir, and the dancers for their outstanding performance. We would also like to thank 88.5 for broadcasting the graduation ceremony live. We are also appreciative of the graduating committee's hard work. We would also like to show our gratitude towards our graduating colleague, Tonya Descartes, for excellent poetic presentation. We want to express our gratitude to our guest speaker, Ms. Safia Solomon, for a motivational speech. The part that resonated with me the most was when she said, "Persons that don't embrace and adapt to new things will be left behind." This shows us that in order for us to move forward and be successful, we must adapt to change. Your words inspired us and they will be remembered. We express our sincere appreciation to Ms. Joelle Charlemagne, the past principal of the Soufriere Comprehensive Secondary School and the current education officer for District 8. I can promise you that she did everything in her power to support our academic growth, and we are grateful for her commitment to contributing to our development. I would like to thank the acting principal, Ms. Combi, and the acting vice principal, Mr. Williams, the current and past teachers on staff at ACSS, who worked tirelessly to ensure the success, distinguished guests, family and friends, and all those who helped us achieve this milestone. We appreciate the Ministry of Education's representative's presence. Please thank the team at the Ministry of Education on our behalf for the support they have given this institution and consequently the graduates of this class over the years. We sincerely appreciate the district representative, Honorable Emma Hippolyte, for being here today. We also want to express our sincere gratitude to all our special visitors and well-wishers, both those who could join us in person and those who couldn't for various reasons. We really appreciate the support of all our sponsors, notably Anshasni and Jade Mountain Resorts. Without your consistent financial support of SCSS, we would not be able to commemorate such a once-in-a-lifetime event. Our school has benefited from your ongoing assistance and cooperation, which has allowed us to experience positive development and achieve success in our endeavors. Your efforts made it possible for this event to proceed without a hitch today, and we sincerely thank you for that. Our parents, who are undoubtedly our biggest supporters, deserve heartfelt thanks that is unfathomably sincere. We all agree that the only true way to show you how much we appreciate you is by making sure that your investments will not be made in vain. Your advice, inspiration, and support are what drive us to aim high. Every student looks forward to graduating from secondary school after 5 years, and today our goal has come true. This is a significant milestone in the path of our lives, one that needs to be acknowledged for its enormous importance. It is an act of pride as well as dedication to oneself. To get to this day, we all put in a lot of effort, and our efforts have brought forth real fruit. Graduation, however, is not the end. All our successes should be viewed as stepping stones for future successes and growth, because life is a journey. It was not my aim to leave out anyone, especially those who contributed in the background. So if I do, I humbly ask for your pardon. Again, a sincere thank you to everyone who helped make this event both possible and unforgettable. God bless you abundantly for your generosity, selflessness, and kindness. From the bottom of our hearts, we appreciate you.
Thank you, Mr. Mungaru, for these thoughtful words. Those who do not adapt will be left behind. You came here as graduates. You leave here as graduates. So you no longer have to come back the next term. But you should come back and visit. We enjoy your visits. Please come back.
Okay, Mr. Fiodil.
So to the graduating class of 2023, we want to give you free chairs. So the parents at the back, help me with free chairs. Now you have to take it and take it proud. You work hard, right? Free chairs for the graduates. Hip hip hip.
Hooray.
Hip hip hip.
Hooray.
Hip hip hip.
Hooray.
Hats off to you, students. The journey is just beginning. Forget how you started and ended SCSS, for these are just but 5 years of your life. You have the rest of your life to write that book. Okay? Your journey is unique. Embrace your journey. So congratulations to the future doctors. Congratulations to the future nail technicians. Congratulations to the future mechanics and policemen, or whatever field that you wish to enter. I want to say congratulations to you. We have come to the end of our graduation ceremony. The students, the graduates, and parents, as well as the dance group, the choir, your refreshments will be at the St. Isidore's Hall. And the specially invited guests, you will receive instructions immediately after the ceremony to know where you go for your refreshments. At this time, for the final time, students, we are going to stand and we are going to sing what? Our school's anthem. Let's sing that with pride and dignity, steadfast in work and example. Let's all stand as we do our school's anthem. Mrs. Hippolyte and Mr. Louise, we call on the two of you to raise and to lead our school's anthem. Remain standing as the graduates take their final walk down the aisle.
bottles, empty bottles. Take your belongings with you. Please pick up all your belongings as we exit the church.
Gentle reminder to all that when you're leaving, please take all your belongings. Please take all your belongings. Also, I have one beautiful sunglasses right here on a slim. Again, reminder, take all that you came with. Not what you've not came with, come with, but take all that you came with.